Between games at tonight's doubleheader, a local disc jockey blew up disco records in center field, and a crowd responded by rushing the field. Police moved in, and it took them a considerable amount of time. A bonfire had been built in the middle of center field. Police tried to clear the unruly crowd, pushed them out, finally got them off the field, although, again, it took a long time. Perhaps some arrests, it's hard to tell. Some people appear to be taken into custody. We don't know the exact nature of everything that's gone on out there so far, but NewsCenter 5 staffer Mike Pumo is out there at Comiskey Park, and we have him on the phone right now. Mike?
Hello. Jim?
Yes, what's the current situation?
They just canceled the second game.
They canceled the second game
because the field is unplayable, as determined by the umpires.
Also, would they have run into a problem with the fact that they had such a long delay because of this?
Yeah, there's a 1 a.m. curfew, and so they would have had to complete the game by 1 a.m., but the main reason was because the umpires determined that the field was unplayable.
They had to clean it up, I suppose. It looks like there's a lot of litter out there from the picture we have.
Right. What happened was that they had an anti-disco demonstration between the games, and the fans stormed the field, and they set a bonfire in center field, and they also ripped up some turf in front of the pitcher's mound, about a foot wide and about 10, 12 feet long. And they had a meeting with Sparky Anderson and Don Kessinger and Bill Vecht, and one of the supervisors of the umpires was here along with the head umpire. And after that meeting, I guess they've decided to cancel the game.
Okay. Any injuries that you know of?
Not that I know of. We have no reports of any arrests either as of right now.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Okay. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.
Mike Pumo, who was out there at that White Sox game and saw what you just saw and more, I guess.